Hello, Guilty Gear fans! This is ShadowFury333 with something a little bit different from my normal fare. For those of you who aren't familiar with my general stuff, normally I cast replays of an RTS game called Zero K. It's basically based off Total Annihilation, something of a like fan game in a sense, based on Total Annihilation. That's my main thing, but on the side, I do fighting games, and Guilty Gear Xrd just came on PC, which is awesome. So I'm going to be doing stream of that, and probably doing more than just this one at some point. I don't plan to just have a one-off for this, but we'll see. I do want to point out the RTS thing, though, just because I'm going to be speaking a lot to people who are familiar with those casts, because I've been using a lot of vocabulary that's from Guilty Gear. And I kind of want to explain that, and there's also some other things I'm going to talk about that would be related to that, but I'm also just going to talk about Guilty Gear, because Guilty Gear's cool. So, network play. Let's go with that. The online for this game, unfortunately, is not rollback, but it's, for non-rollback play, fine. It does the job. Oh. Except there's a bit of a weirdness with ranked matching. So I'll probably just do lobbies. I was hoping I'd be able to get some ranked matches today, but apparently that is not in the cards. Oh, how about that? Never mind, it actually is in the cards. Let's loosen up a bit. A new assassin. See, I've actually been playing Guilty Gear kind of. Like, I haven't been playing Xrd much, but I played Guilty Gear is actually the game I learned fighting games on. Well, Accent Core specifically is the game I learned fighting games on. And unfortunately, that also meant I learned a lot of bad habits, so I'm not the best player by any means. Which, of course, you're going to wonder, why am I playing Millia? Because if you know the game at all, you know that Millia is not an easy character to play. And that's true, she is not. However, she is also the only character of my mains that's actually in Xrd at the moment, with Jam and Dizzy not yet in. Both of them will be coming in the next version, but they're currently not in now. Alright. What? They got through that? Ah, I thought I could Roman cancel my way out of that one. Ah, shoot. That wasn't what I wanted to do. I wanted to do, because, so, for those of you not familiar, Millia's game plan is basically lock the opponent down and then stop them from playing the game. Which I know sounds really cruel, but it usually doesn't work out as well as the plan. But yes, the plan is basically knock them down, and then every time you knock them, man, that's hard to do. Every time you knock them down, you set up a disc, or you set up her long-range ball move, which is great for dealing with this sort of thing. Well, that's... Wow, that actually worked. Did not expect that to work. Ah. Darn it. That was the time to block. Well, that went poorly. Oh, well, actually, not too badly, but yeah, I didn't manage to get it off. So basically, the idea is you knock them down, and then you set up tandem top on top, you set up a disc on top, or you set up, she has another move that basically fires a ball at them, and then you just control that around. That's her game plan. And then when you do that, then you also just hit them as they're blocking, because they're forced to block. So that is the general game plan. And not terribly surprised there aren't a lot of people online for ranked. There's a lot for lobbies. I checked lobbies earlier. There's tons of lobbies. But when this game first came out, there was some region locking issues. And I don't know if there still might be. That you could... You can play people across regions. And Steam download regions is what I mean. You can play people across regions, but it wouldn't give you ranked matches. And ranked matches were actually automatically exited. It was a bug that got patched. Oh, and I hate fighting this Venom. This character and another one who may come up later who looks like a doctor with a bag on his head, Faust. Those are my least favorite characters to fight against. Darn it. I'm not sure exactly why they're my least favorite characters to fight against, other than the fact that people I play with the most, well, one of them uses both those characters, and they're just annoying to play against. Like, it's annoying to play against that person. That's good. Darn it! Oh, right, that was the thing I was going to talk about, was... So I use certain terms, in particular, burst. Actually a term I use a lot when I'm talking about 0K, which is actually... I'm not referring to anything other than the mechanic in this game. You just saw me use it and fail. But basically, you can... Every once in a while, there's a bar in the bottom right corner... Sorry, top right corner, which shows... Oh, why not from the discount? It shows... Well, it says burst. When that's full, you can hit a couple buttons, and then you will basically get out of whatever's happening. I use that to refer to the Commander Explosion 0K because basically I feel like it works the same way, where it just causes you to completely have no pressure on you anymore. Like, any units that were around are dead, but the commander is still... Well, they're dead, so you lose a resource. I mean, as you can see, I can only do burst so often. Actually, it's not very often at all. Not very often at all. Except now. But I think they're going to roam cancel. No, they didn't roam cancel out of that. Wow, I expected them to do... I don't even know why I did this. That was not the direction I wanted to go. I thought I'd jump over that. Anyway, no, I didn't want to do... I wanted... She's another move of these, the similar motion what I just did. That's the opposite direction that I wanted to do. That would have been the better option. Yeah, so burst, whenever I say burst in my 0K casts, I'm referring to the Guild Gear mechanic, which I think has an analogous setup to the Commander Explosion, the Commander Death Explosion, and how that works. So I feel like that is basically a nice analogy, but overall, yeah, this the match has been cancelled thing. I don't know if that's... There we go. That happened all the time before. So yeah, that's what I'm referring to. And other than that, one of the biggest things that... Not so much any specific mechanic of Guilty Gear that's analogous to 0K, but more the general design philosophy. I might actually play other characters besides Millia in Lobby just to show what other characters do. You can kind of see the differences between characters, but it's not obvious just from watching necessarily. But basically... Characters in Guilty Gear are very different from each other. It's not as obvious as, say, Blaze Blue, where there's every single character has their own meter. But, like, are their own meter or a very specific thing. They have a button that's basically character-specific move. That's not the case in... Darn it. That is not the case in Guilty Gear. Got me during the startup. But anyway, the general principle of Guilty Gear is that there's a couple of fairly universal mechanics for defense and for general action. Like, I was trying to show it off there. Trying to show Fallow's defense there, but you have that tension bar in the bottom that controls pretty much everything you can do defensively and offensively. It controls supers, it controls fault, like, which is typical because that's basically your super meter. It also controls a defensive mechanic, follows defense, which pushes your opponent away but requires tension to use. It controls Roman cancels, which allow you to spend a bit of meter to cancel out of a move, which is great for getting out of a bad situation. Ah, shoot. I keep forgetting you rise me burst. It also, and Exert specifically pauses the game. That's a new thing to Exert. Earlier versions didn't have that effect, but yeah. Gotta put down the discs. But yeah, so the point is there are common mechanics, many of which focus around the tension bar, but most of which are just common mechanics. And there are other ones as well. but a lot of it is very character specific. Like, very character specific. So you have Millia with her lock you down completely style of play. Then you have Venom, which you saw earlier with the pool balls. That's just set up pool balls and then do other stuff. Kai was fighting before is fairly straightforward with projectile pressure. And then... and another Venom, okay. Actually, it's the same Venom as before. But, yeah, so Venom's setup is getting pool balls out and then hitting them. Which is very specifically Venom. That's something that only Venom does. And this... oh, seriously, 10 frames of delay? I'm gonna go to the lobby after this. Alright. Wow. Yeah, one of the biggest reasons why this game does work okay on not great connections is because it's actually not that quick. There's a lot of things, a lot of time you have to respond to things when you've done them, noticing. But at the same time, this is really annoying! Shoot. And I find that similar, anyway, the thing I was referring to, I find similar to the way that in 0K you end up, ah, shoot. Big punch kick in that situation. Ah, right, the dead angle's a forward punch. Anyway. Yeah, so it's time to respond. But my point is regarding 0K is that the way the game is designed, and it's very strongly designed in a way that you have a lot of distinction in every single option you have offensively. Well, every single option your character has, basically. And that just reminds me of the way the factories work in 0K. Factories compared to defenses, where defenses are seriously? Where defenses are basically... darn it. Where defenses are basically something you can build no matter what you're doing. They're perfectly symmetric, but then once you build a factory, you're stuck with that factory. Right, I don't have enough room to cancel. Oops. Darn it. I make that mistake all the time. That's one of the bad habits that I was talking about before. It's getting too close, getting blocked, and then getting thrown because I got blocked. No, that's gonna get blocked. And that was an instant kill move, which I'm not gonna try using right now, but yeah, now they have no tension. Not that it matters, but whoever wins... hey, it was me! Whoever wins is gonna win just off of normals at this point. Yeah, I mean, obviously there's some aesthetic differences as well, like the fact that Millia uses hair. Yeah, okay. But that's not what I'm referring to. I'm referring to more mechanical differences. But it's... I was making reference to BlazBlue, though, because BlazBlue, I find a little bit less... like, a little bit more specific that there's differences. But it's more contained. Like, you don't have... there is no, this is my character-specific move in Guilty Gear button. That button does not exist. Ah, this is annoying. Darn it. This is a position I hate being in, Millia. Well, if you're playing Millia at all, this is not a position you want to be in. Wow, that was a bad idea. I cannot believe I got away with that. Okay, I'm not surprised I didn't get away with that. That was a very bad idea. What I just did there was wrong. The guild's second best operative. I will that was the wrong way to do it. Okay, one more rank match, but if I get the same ping, then I'm just going to go to lobbies. So yeah, because of that setup, and it's because of the fact that it's smeared across the character, because those differences are just smeared across the entire character, I feel like that matches up with the way that 0K, like it has... you have the roles. Each factory has its different units, different roles. You have the Raider, the Riot, the Skirmisher. But how they actually work, the specifics of how those units work, vary wildly between factory. It's also one of the reasons I really like the fact that pretty much every... there's all these units that have unique weapons in Guilty Gear. Sorry, in 0K. And the fact that... that reminds me of the way that things work in Guilty Gear just makes me really like how that works in 0K. because it just... Ah! Darn it. Sheesh. That was not what I wanted to have happen. In case you're wondering, the move that just knocked me in the air like that, which... That move is an overhead. I can't block it low. For those of you not familiar. I can't believe I actually blocked that. That was a guess. That was like... This, the ping is too high to actually... I think it's too high to actually block Greed Sever. I'm not totally sure. Ah. Oh, great. Not what I wanted to do, but whatever. I can't get out of it right now. Oh, crap. Whoa, I actually... So we both won the instant kill, and I won it. I won the instant kill fight. I can't even believe that happened. I'll take it. Why am I doing it that way? I keep reading slash. Gotta start with slash. That's the one thing I have a hard time with this game in. Darn it. Not what I wanted at all. Oh, I don't have my burst yet. Shoot, that's why. Man, I won an instant kill fight and I still lost the match. Oh well. That was just weird. I can't believe that happened. I'm still super surprised that happened. But anyway, let's find lobbies. So yeah, the way that everything is very distinct, but yet has... There are archetypes it sort of kind of fits into, but it still feels like the categorization is slightly forced. Yeah. Guild Gear is totally like that. Wow, I don't know where to... This has got the best ping, apparently. I don't want to set it just spectating. I don't know this game well enough to commentate on it. Although I suppose I could point out the things I was actually trying to talk about while playing. If I'm spectating. Well, this has got enough players. Should be able to just find a match. One thing I kind of wish Exo would allow you to do is go into training mode while waiting. I'm really surprised they don't have that as a thing. It really should be. Okay, so, let's see, what was I going to talk about? Differences, the way the design works out, the way the burst works. Not sure what else. I don't know. The possibility of a Roman cancel style mechanic in an RTS game and how that would work. I don't know. Actually, that'd be kind of neat. Interesting. I wonder how that would work. If you had, like, cancels of some kind where you just... No, not really. It doesn't really work. The only game I can think of that was kind of like that was Akron because of the time travel mechanic. Okay, that's a bit of a silly tangent. Also, this is clearly not going to work out. Try again for lobby, but I'm a little concerned. Okay. More people are here. Oh. Hey, someone else joined. There's a lot of Millias. I mean, I'm probably gonna... Yeah, Millia Mirror right now. We have a Millia Mirror, which... Have I fought this one before? Millia Mirror with Millia voice pack, Millia everywhere. I hope you like Millia. Okay. I feel like I fought this one before. I have fought a million before. I actually beat them both times. That was the time for Secret Garden. Catch me pressing buttons. I don't know if this will work, because it worked! Oh crap, I got nothing. Oh wait, no, I do. I do have stuff. I have meter. And so do they, but that's fine. Ha! I went! Now, funny story, I play Millia partly because one time at a family event, I was playing with my cousin, which is actually the person who plays Faust and Venom a lot, and he was complaining to me about my playing Jam, because for those of you not familiar, Jam is a character who wears kind of this leotard skirt setup, and it's not the most tasteful thing, but Guilty Gear is, like, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Well, it's rock and roll the video game, and so you get some of the outlandish fashions that you would expect from rock. But, yeah, it's... I can't go into my... Chroming Rose mirror. So anyway, so Jam is a bit outlandish that... Wah. Okay, you're gonna be doing something silly right there. What? Ah, there we go. Good, I got it. Awesome. Anyway. So, basically he was worried that one of our younger cousins' mother, one of our aunts, would complain about Jam having this really short skirt and showing all the leg. And so basically forced me to play another character if I wanted to play at all. So then I picked Millia, but at the time, in Accent Core, Millia actually... Millia was... Like, the way that my opponent has their costume set up without the leggings, that's how Millia was up until Exert. More or less. She looked worse. The extra design's awesome for Millia. But, anyway. So, I ended up just picking one of the... Like, it was only worth because I picked one of the alternate color schemes for Millia that had leggings. So, I just find it interesting the way things turn around like that. But it was just funny because, basically, Millia wasn't any better than Jam in terms of if you're worried about being about prudish aunts, although admittedly I don't think she's actually that much of a prude. But still, if you're worried about prudish aunts, but yeah, that's a thing. But wow, they got a game on me. How about that? It's just kind of funny because Millia should in theory be no better at, in Accent Core, because by default no. But hooray for color palettes, I guess. Of course, the other character I played, Dizzy, is even worse than Jam as far as if you're a prude. Guilty Gear is the sort of game that is going to annoy you. Not, like, make you get the vapors or whatever, but just annoy you. Just go, you know, you think, oh man, you could have just done so much to make it not so prudish, and then, of course, that's bullshit, but like I said... shoot. Missed that. Like I said, rock and roll video game. Or rock and roll the fighting game, rather. Oops. Didn't want to lose that at all. Ow. Ow. Sheesh, they actually took a game off me. Anyway. Yeah, I thought that was funny. Yeah, so if you're really prudish, this game is going to annoy you. But if you're not, then yeah, it's cool. Although, honestly, by far the most prude baiting character there is Eno, which I don't think we'll see. And that... Yeah, it's kind of hard to describe her, honestly. Oops. Whoa, I didn't expect that to hit! They ran right into that. I gotta remember, if I go for a dust, just go for... have the follow-up on my stick just the entire time. Ow. That's not what I want. Nah, that's not gonna work. Come on, don't do this. That was a secret guard time if there ever was one. They're gonna block this, I'm sure. Oh, yeah. No, not quite. Ah, I thought I could roam. Oh, I can't roam and cancel out of that. I didn't have enough meter. So close. I thought I did. Nope. Oops. Come on. Nope, not what I wanted to do. Not at that point, anyway. I'm relying way too much on burst here. Wow, that was bad. Ow. I think I got chipped out there. Crap, I think they've downloaded me by now. I do want to kind of show a different matchup, though. I'll play against this person one more time and then see if I can find a different matchup to show. Because, I mean... the Millia party is okay. I don't mind the Millia party. It's just that it's... not necessarily the... it's not the only part of the game there is. There are more characters than Millia, and I'm trying to... Oops. Ah, shoot. Come on. Oh, I can't believe I actually managed to hit with that. That's not a move to use in neutral. That was one too many Roman cancels. One is fine, two is too many. Why'd I do two Roman cancels in a row? Darn, gotta do kick. That was badly timed. Almost blitz shielded it out there. Darn it. That is such a hard air dash to get right. Like, I normally instant air dash just fine, but for whatever reason, the instant air dash cancel off of that... off of that move is really hard for me to do. Shit. I let go of Faultless Defense there. So close. Alright, okay, there's a Kai. Oh, I was playing Kai earlier. Where is it? I want to find someone that's not Millia. I also kind of wanted to use someone who wasn't Millia, but I think I might pass on that one. What? Okay, we'll try another rank match. The lobby finding stuff is weird. That, and I think it should probably show full lobbies with a bit of... Huh. Oh wait, this is a Kai player, wasn't it? I think it was. Yeah, I do kind of wish it would show the lobbies, and even if they're full, just show them anyway. But anyway. Probably the last few matches before I stop this stream. But oh, for those of you who are a bit curious about some of the terms I was using for 0K and some of my design arguments, I mean, I'm not really designing the game much, but things I often speak in favor of. Yeah, Guilty Gear is a huge motivation for that. What the heck happened to... Where are they? Hey. There we go. Oh, hey, there we go. Someone completely different. There's actually a new character in Exerd. Come to think of it, I haven't really shown any of the new characters in Exerd. Oh well, they'll come up. So I don't really like fighting Sin. Sin's annoying because that bar in the corner that with the food, like. It's basically, he can cancel moves using that meter. Darn it. Ow. Hey, I'm actually getting somewhere against the Sin. I was playing Sins earlier, and they're just... Sin's a pain in the butt to fight. Whoa. Okay, I didn't realize Sin had that super. Not that it mattered, since I blocked it and didn't have to worry about it at all. Oh. Darn it, that was the secret garden time. I did the Millia comic thing. Which I guess that's why it's a comic. Darn it. There we go! Took you down. Well, okay, it's 1-1. We'll see how this goes. You can kind of sometimes get three jump dusts into... How did I air dash backwards? Ow! Not what I wanted. Right up. What? IK mode? Okay. Not that I did any good, but okay. You do that. Note, if you go into instant kill mode, you lose your tension, and then once your tension's out, you lose your health. So anyone's not aware, going in instant kill mode, especially at low tension, which my opponent was at, is a great way to lose. But you actually put up a good fight. This is kind of although admittedly, if they had hit me, then it would have been game over. And it wasn't that double IK situation as before. But yeah, I think that'll be my last match for tonight, so I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. And I like talking about this stuff because I've been meaning to talk about this stuff in the context of 0K forever. Which admittedly, for people who are pure Guilty Gear fans just watching it because it's Guilty Gear, I'm sorry, that might have been hard to follow. But, I mean, when it comes to Guilty Gear stuff, I know some things, but I'm not super knowledgeable. Working on it. But yeah. If you are interested in playing an RTS game, 0K is probably the most fighting game-like RTS game there is. There's not much in the way of tech. You get to, I mean, like, tech levels. You don't have to build a lot of stuff to build things. So you basically have all your units available, and you're kind of selecting units based on what's appropriate for the situation rather than just what you can build based on the time in the game. You have that same level of flexibility with units in 0K as you do with moves in a fighting game. And the same rough level of specific purpose. In the sense that moves in a fighting game and units in 0K are both, they have their purpose, they have the thing they're used for. They do a thing well, rather than being generalist. So anyway, that's just a bit of a side note. So I hope you enjoyed that, and that is going to be it for me tonight. Thanks for watching, everybody. And have a good night.